Hello, and welcome to Horror and Monster Collectibles, where today we are going to be taking a look at the brand new Prime One Studio Alien Big Chap 3D wall art statue. This was a limited run of 100. They also had a DX version with an open mouth. I think that was a run of like 200 or 250, I'm not sure, but this is just the standard edition that had a run of 100. And it's their next piece in their wall art alien line, which I've had some of those pieces, but I ended up selling what I had. And this will be the only one that I keep. And obviously it's from, again, the 1979 Alien film. And it can be displayed as a statue or a wall art, although it's heavy, and I would recommend it being displayed in statue form. So let's take a look at how we got here. All right, guys, so first up, we will show the assembly instructions. And as always, it shows the layout of the foam trays and the parts. And then on the back, we have the assembly instructions. And you guys can pause this if you need to look at it in closer detail. I kind of like showing these for people who in the future may have lost the instructions or bought it used and don't have it. But anyway, here they are. So first up, obviously, we start with a base, which I will kind of show you guys in detail. Kind of come down here. Show you the sides of the base. It is heavy. It feels pretty close to solid polystone. I think it's got some hollowness to it, but it's pretty stout. And it is about 17 inches wide at the base. Now here we can see the key slots for Big Chap himself. And then the back wall. And here is that back wall installed. It's not terribly heavy. I would say probably like 10 to 15 pounds. It's not a solid piece, but it's still pretty stout. Take a look at all of the detailing here, which there is lots of it. I do really like the weathering that they have going on. Some nitpick stuff though is like this rust that they've tried to mimic just looks pretty cheesy, and unfortunately that's kind of throughout, which I don't get because they have nice coloring throughout here, and then they just put these spots on, which is really, really curious because look, it's like everywhere. So I think what I'll end up doing is coming back through here and repainting these spots, because they kind of bother me. They look really out of place. Maybe not on film, but in real life they do. Let's pull away for a little bit. Come down. Now the base did key in fairly easily, and it does feel pretty sturdy. I wouldn't really worry about that back wall moving too much. It does look good together. There's not too much of those brown spots on the base, but man, like there are all over here. And I don't get it. Like it just look really, really out of place. It's weird, weird choice. Let's go ahead and spin this thing around for you real quick, and I'll show you the back, which they did bother to paint the back, which is nice. But again, just more of those weird brown spots. I can get them in focus for you. It'd be helpful, right? It's weird. I don't like it. Other than that though, like it looks really good. There's lots of good coloring throughout there. I really enjoy it. they did like such a terrific job on all this. It's just like, what is going on with that? Doesn't even make sense. But I'm going to have to fix it, I guess. Even down through here on the piping on the sides, lots of good texture and paintwork. Let's look at Big Chap himself. Alright guys, so as you can see, my Big Chap arrived with some damage. This dorsal tube is broken off, and it's just a real shame. The way they packaged this thing was really, really crappy, and I will show you the foam tray and the issue with it in a moment, but I'll go over the body here. Also, like, they kept these as one piece, so they assembled these after they painted them, and then they glued them and kind of painted them, but they didn't color match, and you can see the seam. So I don't understand why they'd shipped it with it on there. Like, why not just have that four pieces that the collector assembles himself? You didn't really gain much except for shipping damage. And it's in the back of the statue, so nobody's gonna see it anyway. I just don't understand. But you can see those joints. Now, other than that, the paintwork on here is nice. And we'll take a good look at him once he's on the base, but I just kind of wanted to show you this part. And he was also damaged on the toe. If I can get it in focus, you can see here how the toenail chipped. And basically what happened here is it shot through the front of the styrofoam, which I will show you that in a second. Let's get him on the base. All right guys, so real quick, I just wanted to show you the issue with the packaging here. Now, Big Chop obviously sits in here through this tunnel, but there's only these two little walls right here and right here to support them. And what the problem is when this box is laid, was sit down on its bottom when the box is vertical, there's nothing to support this from hitting hard if somebody drops it or, you know, slams it down off a dolly hard, and the whole statue shifts down. And when it happens, like on here, those dorsal tubes break this piece of foam. And unfortunately, mine broke off when it impacted that. And then this other piece right here just breaks off. And that's the only support it has. And you come up through here, that front leg is just floating out here in nowhere. So what happens is that front foot bursts through the front of the styrofoam on the box, which is right here. So yeah, that kind of sucked. I am not the first to report damages on this statue. Another thing that they've done here too, so I had a fellow collector had a broken tail. Well, the problem is they have this tail right here on the corner of the box, and there's not a lot of material right here to protect it. So his tail broke off, which is understandable. And they need to do a better job on packing these things. But it's pretty much a solid polystone statue with a huge metal rod for the base of the foot going up the leg to support it. And they just had some little weak styrofoam bracing to hold it in place and expect it to go from Japan over to America without damages. And of course, unfortunately for me, that did not happen. All right, so that frustration aside, there is the Big Chap body on the statue. It did key in well. It has a sturdy rod going up through the left foot. I don't know how far that extends up the leg, but I assume a bit. It doesn't feel like I'm going to have a lean issue with this at all. It feels very, very sturdy. Up next, we are going to install the tail. Let's get this guy in focus. It has a magnet feature. Get a good shot of the detailing on the tail, which it, all the sculpt work looks really, really well done. I know I have some frustration with the breakages, but I don't want to take away from the artistry on the person or people who sculpted this, because they did a fantastic job on this big jet. The paintwork too, overall, is very well done on this piece. I will say though that the gloss on the body is kind of inconsistent. Some places are kind of flat or like a satin. Other places have more of a gloss, and that's true on the tail and on the body. But let's get this tail installed. All right, so the tail installed very easily, and it has a decent magnet lock. I'm not really worried about the tail falling off of the body anytime soon. Let's go ahead and look at the arms, as that is what's next to be installed. So here we have some pretty decent paintwork here. Now we'll say that a lot of this detailing isn't as good as the dog alien, but it's still fairly good. And there's a magnet feature here and a nice long key. We'll go down the forearm. Again, really nice sculpt work throughout here though. Come here to the underside. And we'll go here through the hand. Just have a little piece of fuzz stuck to that. But nice crisp lines. It's cast very cleanly. I will say though, they did not chrome these nails. And I imagine they did not chrome the teeth either, but the toenails and the fingernails are just a silver and not a chrome, so I'm going to have to fix that as well. I don't understand why these details are so hard to get. I mean, everybody knows it's chrome, not silver. Other than that, the coloring is done fairly well. And just real quick, we will look at the other arm, but it's just more of the same. But I did want to go ahead and show you it. But really, really nice detailing throughout here. Again, it's like they make it so far and then just phone in key simple details like chrome or packaging. I don't really understand it. Let's get those installed. All right, so they're the arms. They installed without issue and they had good strong positive locks on them. Up next, we're going to install this guy on the back. It too has a magnet key feature with good detailing, nice paint app on here. I think though, along with the other things I need to fix, like the dorsal tube and the chrome on the teeth and nails, I think I'm going to have to uniform the gloss coat on him. That went on without issue. And again, if you're going to do like pieces like that separate, then why on earth did you do the dorsal tubes attached to the body? Why were they not separate pieces to minimize the risk of damages, especially when you have kind of an obscene paint joint, paint and glue joint seam on there in the first place? If you had put them on there because you wanted to minimize that seam, I get it, but you weren't successful in that, and now you have rigid tubes on the torso, and it didn't hold up to shipping. And it's on the back of the statue. I don't understand. Anyway, I'll collect myself, move on. We're gonna look at the head. So here is the head. And it too has issues. You can see right here how they didn't line up this upper lip piece. So the tendons don't line up here. You can kind of see this guy's off, and same with this one. We'll come look through here to the front, and yes, it is just silver teeth. On this side, they did line it up, and that's in the proper location. Again, you can see as a comparison, well, that is not. And over here, it is. The paintwork on the head, however, and the sculpt work is very nice. Again, more crisp details. These came out of the mold, really clean. Let's take a look at the top dome. And they did like a really, really good job capturing that kind of milky, opaque-ish look. Like translucent. But they did a real good job on capturing that while having like that shaded tone underneath. There is a hard line here on this though, and it should be more faded, but most companies kind of get that wrong. The detail work underneath the dome though looks fairly good, although it does get a little sloppy in here. That's just static stuck to it. The head was packaged very well and securely, so I'll give them that. But wish they had done the same for the body. Let's take a look underneath. While I'm talking about, you know, them, I'll also give credit where credit's due, and I do appreciate that they attached the dome to the head, unlike the Megurai, which was not. It was kind of a pain in the butt for us collectors, as the fitment had some issues. So this is nice that it comes complete and the fitment is nice and tight. And honestly, it's done very well. So let's get that on. So the head installed without any issue is looking good. Don't worry, I will show you an up close view of this. I'm just kind of going through the assembly process right now. I'll also do a 360 video spin of them. Up next, we need to install this piece, which is on the throat. Kind of joins the head to the body, which I like that they kept this separate so there's not a seam line going through here. So that is pretty nice. And then, of course, we have the two tubes. So let's get those on. All right, guys, so I got those tubes installed, but they were kind of a pain in the butt. They don't label which one goes where. It is fairly easy to figure out, but unfortunately, my left tube kind of got some warpage during shipping, so it didn't fit right. I'm going to probably have to heat it up and stretch out the bend, just a hair on it, to get it to fit in properly, but it's in there for now. And then finally, for assembly, we put the tubes on the base. Let's go ahead and look at those real quick. Nothing special going on here. It's just to add some detailing to the base to make it look a little bit more interesting. I got this guy, and then we got this guy right here. Little squinched up dude. So it Let's get those on. All right, guys, so you made it this far. Let's look at this guy up close. Now, we'll say real quick, what I did is I ended up heating up this guy with the hairdryer, like right there on that bend, just to kind of get some flexibility in him. And you just want to heat it just a little bit so it's got some give and doesn't snap. I was able to lessen that bend on it a little bit and get it to fit in the hole a whole lot better. Again, it kind of just changed a little bit during shipping. Let's go ahead and take a good look at this guy. Again, he looks impressive and the detail work on him is well done. I do not understand what's going on back here though. Again, you can clearly see the seam from their glue job on here. They could have just easily left that a separate piece that you just attach on instead of having breakage like this. Now I got this guy just kind of slammed down on there for right now to kind of help hide the gap so I can get some pictures, but I'm going to have to use some filler and color match the paint on here and get that fixed up. Or Prime One is going to send me a replacement. I have no idea because I haven't heard from them. And I contacted them about 5 days ago. Come down through here. Again, just really insane detail work. This is a very, very impressive big chap. It's just a shame that they have these issues on a piece that only has like 100 edition size on this one. And then I think, I can't remember what the other one has, maybe like 200, 250. It's small, regardless. And unfortunately, down in here, you can't really see, if I can get it focused, see better, but you can't really see the chip on the toe. So I think what I'll do here is I'll just paint underneath where it's messed up and just leave that be. And then, of course, paint the teeth and toenails and fingernails silver. Let's get a good look at the tail. Up through here. Again, I'll do like a 360 view of him, but I just kind of wanted to get you guys these shots. And there is really good paint work on here. Some of it's a little bit odd, like this little pattern here seems odd. I don't think it's painted as well as the Dog Alien, which is a piece I love, but this is still a very good piece. Come back through here. You can see, again, you can see their work on attaching that. And it's just, it was a curious choice, and I think it was a bad choice, especially in the way that it's packaged. And again, you can see like some areas like here are like high gloss. Other areas are more of a satin. So I think I will do more of a uniform. Even when you get down here to the hand, it's more of a satin. So I think I'll do more of a uniform gloss coat on him. The tendon not lining up here on the mouth is kind of unfortunate, but it doesn't bother me too much. It's not a detail that most people are going to know. Nobody coming over is going to look at this and be like, hey, that tendon doesn't line up. I don't think, anyway. Maybe they will. Paint work on the teeth leaves a bit to be desired. Can see the inner jaw in here, but again, I will touch all that up, chrome it. Overall, though, I mean, I'm nitpicking. Some of this stuff isn't nitpick stuff. Some of this is major damage to an expensive statue that was easily avoidable if the packaging was engineered correctly. which it wasn't. But he looks great with the back wall. You can choose to display him without that. I am going to have him paired with the Megurai and the cool props, Giger, Maquette. So I think I'm going to keep the back wall on him. Overall, I do love him though. I think he's a pretty freaking awesome piece. Is it as accurate as the Megurai? No, I don't think so. But that was more detailed towards the actual suit versus the concept of Big Chap, and this is more geared towards the concept of Big Chap versus Bellagio in a suit. But this is fantastic and I love it. I'm just a little disappointed. No, I'm more than a little bit disappointed with Prime 1. Alright guys, so after all that, I wanted to show you how he looked in comparison to the cool props Giger Maquette, which is on the left, and then in the center is the Megurai Big Chap, and then finally, obviously, the Prime 1. Now you can see on the Prime 1 that the size is about spot on with the Megurai. The limbs, the arms and legs are a little underscaled, a little bit on the thin side. The Megurai is a little bit more spot on as far as scaling. And really honestly, like overall accuracy, it's hard to beat the Megurai. I mean, they did such a badass job on it. They had some paint issues, and again, the dome didn't come on the statue, and there were some fitment issues with some people, which really was a drawback, but overall, it is probably the best sculpted Big Chap you will ever find, the most accurate as well. The Prime 1 is again a little bit on the thin side, although it still looks great paired with the Megurai. And then over here, obviously, we have, which is hard to see, but we have the cool props Giger Maquette, which is a little bit underscaled as far as 1/3, but still a stunning piece nonetheless. And the three of these guys look just stunning together, and I absolutely love the way this is looking. Now speaking to that, over in this spot right here, I had hoped to put my Ash, but was not able to get him as far as his head and then his torso on the shelf, which I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to do, because I did want to display those together, and unfortunately I can't, but I'll have to figure something out. But for right now, this looks absolutely stunning. Alright guys, so that's about all there is to go over on this piece. Again, overall, I do love it. I'm just a little disappointed. The packaging is a pretty big fail. Again, I'm not the only customer with damage. I know of three others, and that's out of a really low edition size. And I'm sure there's others that I don't even know about. And then as of right now, a lot of people have yet to even receive this statue. Hopefully we are in a minority and most, if not all, other people get this thing safe and sound. That's all I can wish for as far as other collectors. Hopefully they have much better luck than me, Hopefully I hear back from Prime One soon. I say this is disappointing, like, you know, and I know that it may feel like I'm nitpicking this thing, and I might be, but look, I order a lot of stuff from Prime One, and they've had issues with everything that I've ordered as of late, as of the past couple years. The half-scale T800 had its issues. Pennywise, the half-scale Pennywise had its issues. The Jungle Hunter, the quarter-scale Jungle Hunter had its issues. The Jungle Hunter's victim was atrocious. I mean, it didn't even go together. I broke it, like, trying to get it together. And I, again, was not the only one that had that problem. There's some other stuff, too, that I've forgotten in between there. But then this guy, it feels like quality is going down while the prices are going up. And that's really, really, really upsetting as a collector. And I wonder how long my interest will remain in this, because I feel like it's already waning. But for now, I will enjoy this piece. It will make a great display. Hopefully Prime One takes care of me. We'll see. I have no idea. But either I'm going to have to smash this body and they send me another one, which I've heard that they don't have replacements for this, so that they would have to go into a small production run of making replacements for those customers that have them broken and then send those out. So we're looking at 4 to 6 months probably wait time. I don't want to go down that road. I would rather repair this myself, but who knows? I don't know what's going to happen. I might keep you guys posted on that after I do another video on repainting this guy and fixing him up. So I will leave you with a 360 video view of this guy, and I'll leave you with some studio shots like I always do. As always, feel free to leave me questions or comments, and I'll be happy to answer them. They say that he comes in at 60 pounds total. I don't think that he's that heavy, but he's probably 40 to 50 pounds. He might be 60, but he doesn't feel that heavy to me. But I would say that, you know, you're going to need a strong shelf to put this on for sure. So any questions or comments, be happy to answer them. Hopefully you guys dig this. Again, I really like it. I'd be curious to hear what you guys' thoughts are. Those rust spots on the back wall are really, really weird choice. They look out of place and they look like they were an afterthought. I don't really know what was going on with those, but those need to be fixed too. I'm just really tired of getting statues that I have to repaint or repair, which seems to be the norm while these prices are getting outrageous. As always, feel free to like and subscribe and click the bell for notifications for new videos. And until next time, I will see you guys later.